Welcome to Prefabricated Structures. Today's video is related to prefabricated components. As yesterday we have seen behavior of the components of prefabricated. Performance of components. What is the performance? How we require this part of performance for the prefabricated components. Appearance. How we are going to see them, how they are able to view us, means the particular value or the texture is most important in the structures. Whenever we are going to construct them, how nicely it is going to look or how attractive the structure is there. So this appearance, structural capability, load taking capacity of the structure, we have to understand in prefabricated. As in monolithic, the part of loading can be easily understood whether the same thing or same part is taken care into structural capacity of the prefabricated structures, we have to find out. Thermal properties, how much good is the structure in the thermal properties such as temperature variations, fire catch, snowfall or anything. Sound insulation, whether the sound acoustics can be modified or not. Whether the sound is resisted or it is allowed to pass through it. Fire and vermin resistance. Fire and vermin means fire is going to catch or any part of insects or anything is going to get catch. Durability and moisture resistance. How much durable is there? How much days it can come? How much part we can going to utilize? Toxic and breathing ability, smell, whether they are going to come or not. If they are, then what are the remedies we need to see. Sustainability, which is most important, which has to be environmental impact related. We are against the environment or to with the environment. Appearance, the prefabricated structure is better quality control, shape and size of precast elements. So we can see the better quality control and the shape and size of the element is there. The concrete panel with have a light gray color and have a smooth even finish due to high quality mechanized centralized mass production units. Due to the centralized mass production units, we can have a small gray color units. Then quality mechanized centralized things, reduction in the number of joints gives a neat clean image. So we can see the small part of joints are reduced, so less number of joints will going to give us good appearance. The whole panel is prepared as a one single concrete panel, so this whole panel is on a one single concrete panel, or this particular one single concrete panel was constructed and then painted, so for that reason it is getting in a white color. So this particular painted part we can see, so this is in with less number of joints. So these are the appearances of the elements we can easily see. Structural capability, strict quality control can be put into place to ensure high performance in structural design. Full advantage of properties of cement and steel can be exploited, means it is same as the monolithic construction. A regular RCC slab of 125 mm thickness could actually be only 65 mm thick to cater the load above, since on site formwork limitations do not permit such thin sections. One has to cast minimum 125 mm thick of slab. So we can provide 65 mm thick of slab also, but the formwork cannot provide it and load cannot take by that particular thickness of the slab. For that reason, we need to have a slab of almost thickness 125 mm. Minimum is the 125 mm. And 50% reduction of the cross section area means a similar reduction in material consumption is also there, and dead load on the structural system, precast elements can be used efficiently for most of the building components. So precast can be used for the most of the building components, such as it can be used for beams, roofs, slabs, columns, windowsills, lintels, or the door lintels, window lintels, like that. Precast slabs and beams can be designed to carry live load, dead load as per requirements with safety factors incorporated. So we can say that the slabs and beams can be carrying a live load and dead load as per the requirement with also the safety factors incorporated. If we do, it is most popularity for the particular type of construction. Additional slab reinforcement or additional reinforcement could be placed while filling up the joints. So when we are going to fill the particular joints, we can able to place the additional reinforcements also, and we can cast it. In slab, provided with interlocking system to avoid independent displacement of slab, must be manufactured with M40 grade of concrete in giving durable and strong slab than cast in situ slabs. So the precast slabs, whenever we are going to place them, we need to have the interlocking system in between, which will not allow the single displacement of the single slab panel. In this part, we need to cast the particular slab with the grade of M40 concrete itself only, which will be more stronger and durable as casted at the site itself only, means comparing to the normal concrete. Precast waffle units provide speedy construction with overall saving up to 10% or more, besides avoiding shuttering work. The shape is like an inverted through with a square or rectangle in plan, having lateral dimension up to 1.2 meter. Suitable for a large panels beyond 6 meters in either direction, on lying in grid pattern with a reinforcement and cast in situ concrete joints between them. So we need to find out what are the cast in situ concrete joints in between them, which can be taken into place for the dimension of up to 1.2 meter, which is suitable part, and for larger span if we go, it is beyond 6 meters. Thermal properties. So thermal properties, a precast units having a thin cross sections components of used in roofs and walls should be provided with adequate thermal insulating for better thermal performance. Thermal insulation can come as an integral part of a unit during the manufacture of precast, as a unit is a sandwich. So this we can say this is a two layer. This is a single layer without any thermal insulation. The two layer which is having a insulation and one side of the thickness, and a three layer means this is a insulating part. Three layer, it will come with inside part of the particular sandwich things is going to construct. So here we can see two panels which are of different thickness. This is of one thickness, this is of other thickness, and here we can able to see this is as the sandwich. So this part is the particular part which is provided as the core thermal insulation section. Here we can easily have this particular look on this particular figure. Could be added as an independent insulation layer of the required value, like an dry normal construction practice. So where we are providing a thermocol such that the thermal insulation it should not occur, means outside surface temperature should not be in the inside surface temperature, and inside surface temperature should not be on the outside surface temperature. This we can say this as the temperature maintaining for the buildings. Sound insulation, the same part we can use, the sandwich part or the hollow sectional part. Precast concrete units provide an acceptable degree of insulation. Because of this hollow sections, we are getting the soundproof things, means sound is insulated whenever this part of sound is going to pass. The sound which will travel, which will be observed in this particular hollow blocks and not allowed to move outside this particular hollow blocks. Also in sandwich, if it is going in this particle, it is not able to pass through this. It will be easily dispersed in this particular sandwich part of the panels, and easily can be having a high amount of sound can also be used. these type of constructions nowadays are going in the metro cities, because some of the things which require the high amount of acoustics or high amount of sounds, they use these types of panels for the sound insulation, because they should not disturb others. Fire and vermin precast panels will not burn. If we are going to allow a fire, they are not going to burn. Fire resistance rated construction with a fire is up to 4 hours. It is not able to catch any fire if it is prepared with the some other material than the concrete or mud. And also it has no attacks of vermins or infestation, and also in resistance to mold formation. So this can also be a mold formation which can also resist, because any insects are going to come, they are not able to pass through these parts. So this is a hollow part of a brick which is also known as the sound insulator, and also a good conductor of the bad good conductor for the temperature variation, which will not cover any temperature inside to outside, outside to inside. In this formation it is constructed. This is the open panel. When we construct this panel, it will be looking in this format. This is the prefabricated with some insulation other than the material of concrete and wall which is used, which can carry some fire up to a 4 hours of duration. Durable and moisture resistance due to strict quality control measure. Safe structural design with adequate reinforcements, precast panels are highly durable and low maintenance. So durability is how we can say they perform even well under high humidity conditions or constant wetting. Water absorption is low and most cases do not need a waterproofing coat even in external applications. So we can easily see this side one panel and this side another panel, which is in between having one of the steel cage. So if we take this as the external part and this side as the internal part, whatever the external forces are acting on the structure will be only up to this part, only up to the internal core part. Beyond this internal core, they are not able to transfer from this end to this end in the direction. So this will give us the durability as well as moisture resistance. Durability related to humidity and the temperature variations, and water absorption means whenever in the rainy season it is going to come, that time the things are going to have this water will not enter on the inside surface of the building. For this part, precast structure is most very good. Toxic and breathability. Whenever we see something is sprayed, we are able to have some of the things which is smelling. We nowadays know as a sanitizers are there. We have a different fragrance of sanitizers. We have some are not having any single kind of a fragrance. So it depends upon how the breathability. So there are inert, non-toxic and non-prone of gassing volatile materials. So gassing volatile materials means they sometimes catch a fire also. They sometimes catch a fire also for this particular thing. As a production of these units, unit lakes place in controlled environmental pollution of air, water and sight can be reduced and controlled. If something is going to have a toxic air coming out of them, the panels or something, they need to be placed at near the away part, which should not disturb the society or which should not disturb the habitats. Sustainable environmental impacts. There is a discipline used for a scarce material like cement, steel and timber during the production and use installation as a precast. Although there would be a component transportation involved from production center to site, it helps in the management of raw materials in an efficient way away from the site, reducing the work at the central site, decreasing on-site pollution and keeping the work qualitatively better and reliable. In product precast construction, similar types of components are produced repeatedly, resulting in increased productivity and economy in cost too. So we can see the total part of construction, how it takes. So this is the particular part of preparation where the manufacturing of the precast metal elements, they are stacked, then they are molded into a particular house, the same house which is lifted from a place, a transportation is taking, then the transportation is going to place at the particular fixed place, then this particular roofing cover is also laid on this particular. So now what all the things are involved, we can see the material is required such as a steel and a timber at the production, which is used as an installation at the precast panels. So these are the precast panels which are prepared for this. What the raw materials are provided by the available transportation materials, and also they keep the qualitative worth for better and reliable future, non-polluting, the decreasing site pollution also. Precast construction, similar types of components are produced, the one kind of the same thing, same part of buildings can be prepared, resulting easily and increase in productivity. So we are also able to have economy as the least. So the material wastage is less, economy is less. So we are going to achieve a greater ability in the precast fabricated structures. So we can say precast fabricated structures are most efficient type of construction in this particular era. Thank you. See you in the next video. Till that, have a great day.